And welcome back, everyone, to another exciting episode of Fallout 3. Now, there's actually something that we need to do. Where's it at? Vault 101. Vault 101 emergency frequency found. Yeah, I am the Alpha Omega Radio.
This is an automated distress message from Vault Tech. Vault 101. Message begins.
It feels like you left home a long time ago, but I know you're still out there. I just hope you're still alive to hear this. Things got worse after you left. My father's gone mad with power. If you can hear this, please stop looking for your dad and help stop mine. I changed the door password to my name. If you're hearing this, and if you still care enough to help me, you should remember it.
Message repeats. This is an automated distress.
Alright, yeah, we get it. Tech. Whoa, is it so... Well, that might be why. Whew, talk about some serious nostalgia. We're back at 101, back where the whole damn thing started. I wonder what Amada's dad's been up to exactly. Well, this ought to be interesting, don't you think, Amanda? And Dogmeat, you get to see where I kinda sorta came from, even though you've been to Rivet City. Where I was conceived and born. Exit prohibited by Overseer, strictly enforced. Oh, great. Jim Wilkins. Can't say I knew him. There's a skeleton there. Bad roaches. Steve Armstrong. Ooh, he's got a stealth boy. Can't say I knew him either. Alright, I imagine we're walking into a damn police state. So we must be cautious.
Stop right there.
Whoa.
I don't know how you got in here, but... Hold on. Wait a minute. It's you! I hardly recognized you with all the dust and grime from out there. Guess that explains how you got that door open. You've got more experience with it than most everyone down here combined.
Indeed. So where the hell is Amada? So help me if you've hurt her.
Whoa. Calm down there. Amada's not in any danger. I mean, we're all in a sort of a rough patch, but we've weathered worse.
Have you now?
But sorry to say, if you're back, there's going to be trouble with some folks. And if Amada's wrapped up in it, there'll be trouble for her too.
That's a risk I'm willing to take.
Technically, this means I'm supposed to report her. To tell the truth, I'm supposed to report you being here too. But I've been getting mighty forgetful in my old age, you know? We've got more than enough trouble without me adding to it.
I know. I have to agree. So, what happened down here since I left?
Everything went crazy is what happened. Your dad opened that door. Bugs started attacking and people started going crazy. When the smoke cleared, there were a lot of casualties and not many answers. Didn't help that our doctor had just left either.
Dad would be horrified to know all that if he were still alive.
I'm sorry to hear that. Regardless of how things turned out down here, he was a good friend. I always figured he'd do well outside. Matter of fact, a lot of folks started thinking he had the right idea. He usually did. So, if it was safe out there, why stay down here forever? Well, the Overseer didn't like that one bit and started cracking down on that sort of thought. Guess he didn't plan on you coming back.
Well, let me through. I've got work to do.
I can't do that. Not officially, at least. As much as some of the rebels would like rebels. To talk with you, the Overseer said you weren't welcome back.
Well, tell the Overseer you can
of
kiss
course,
my ass.
If you survived whatever's out there, none of us could stop you if you really wanted to cause problems. But I'd prefer if you don't.
Ah, don't worry.
But out of respect to your dad, I could turn a blind eye. You could slip out and say you were never here. I won't tell a soul.
I'll go see what I can do about all this.
Well, okay. Just be careful down here. The vault's changed, I tell you.
Noted.
Hey.
Red Roach.
Actually, yeah, I might want to switch to my pistol when it comes to dealing with the rads. Oh, Overseer, I'd like a word with you, good sir.
Oh, man. We're opening that door, and to hell with the Overseer's rules.
You know I can't do that, Freddy. Now get back down below before I have to do something we'll both regret.
What?
Okay, I didn't think it'd be that way. Oh, Butch. Whoa.
Crazy, damn it.
Dude, what the hell?
Don't you know enough to stay away?
The hell are you on about? You almost shot Freddy.
I didn't mean to fire. I really didn't. I just wanted to scare him off. But he had a knife. I can't be too careful with those rebels.
Well, calm down there, Zimmerman. Calm down. Or, not Zimmerman. What the hell's your name? Officer Taylor. Gotta go.
Yeah. Don't you know enough to stay?
Look, I gotta go. That's for nearly shooting me.
Hey, what's up?
Asshole. Well, this place has seen better days. Seek the sunshine of friendship. We're all in this together. Okay. Hard work is happy work. Yeah, right. Reactor, upper level. This place is a straight dump.
I have to confess I had a bit of a crush on Butch at one point. Oh.
That's all I have to say about that. Overseer, where are you, you little pissant? Hello, you!
Well, I see you've returned.
I have.
Done with the dust and ruins of the wasteland, are you? Given up looking for Daddy? Thought you could just slink back in like a teen missing curfew? Well, that's too bad. You have no future in this vault. You're tainted.
Huh, if that isn't the pot calling the kettle black, I don't know what is. Tainted? You are the crazy bastard who murdered Jonas.
I assume you're talking about the unpleasantness when you left? Yes? Jonas and your father were endangering the future success of this vault and the safety of its residents.
Oh, really?
I did what I had to do to keep them from destroying all we had achieved here. I only wish I could have prevented it from happening at all.
Don't try to justify your murders and lies. They were never threats.
Spoken like someone who's never had to make difficult decisions. Like someone who's never had to lead. Jonas was leaving with your father. Their departure would lead to others leaving as well. And before you know it, half of the vault would be gone.
And?
And then, our home, the last safe, pure bastion of humanity, would be reduced to a lonely handful of aging holdouts, too few to continue.
You're not protecting your people, you're destroying them. Can't you see that?
I'm afraid you're the short-sighted one here. I'm simply keeping them safe and untouched by the war above. The real danger are the rebels and insurgents who insist on risking all of our lives just to die out there in the wastes. If they weren't trying to throw our lives away like that, we could go back to the peaceful life we once had. Everyone would be happy again.
Why are they rebelling?
I just don't know. Don't they realize how dangerous it is out there? But instead, they would throw away the safety of the vault's isolation just to follow in your footsteps. I can't allow them to do that to themselves or to the rest of us.
I believe I have the solution to all, or to the vault's problems.
To fix what you started? Go ahead, and humor me.
Put a stop to the rebels, just let me have a word with them.
You always have held a certain sway with them that neither I nor my guards have enjoyed. All right, then. Go to my daughter and convince her to leave this rebellious nonsense behind.
All right, buddy boy, but, just for old time's sake.
Guard down.
I love daydreaming about killing you. It never gets old. And this time I got a bigger gun to do it. All right, Amana, time to put your silly little rebellion to rest. Seriously, leave the killing and the rebellion to me. I got an evil empire to take out as it is. We don't need you.
You never should have left, kid. Now we'll make sure nobody ever leaves again.
Is that so? I didn't think so. Oh, Amata. Oh, hello, you.
Go ahead and start something. I dare you.
I'm not here to start something. I'm here to finish something. Maintenance. No, that way. That's where we came from. I believe he fled to the. Or they, oh, shut up. Okay, now I'm going in circles. What the piss? So we gotta go back to the upper level.
It's weird to walk the same halls as where we grew up.
Yeah, to have them look like this, seriously. Alright, lower level. Here? Nope. Not that way. Where to, oh wise and powerful computer? Vault 101. Oh, wait, it's got the wrong damn quest. That's why. Alright, so we do have to go to the lower level. Apartments. Are you gonna attack me?
You don't belong here anymore.
Yeah. Pepper Gomez.
Why won't you just leave us alone? Can't you just leave us alone?
Gotta go. Fine, be that way. I was totally macking on your daughter, by the way. Assuming that's your daughter, perhaps niece. Okay, nobody home there. That's Pepper Gomez. So there's nothing down there. Hey, Aunt Stanley.
I don't know that I should be talking with you.
Gotta go. Ellen DeLoira?
You're back again? It's all kind of blurry for me, but I hear I owe you for saving me. But don't expect much. The whole thing was your dad's fault in the first place.
Oh, whatever. Screw you, ungrateful people.
Morning.
Ugh, you bipolar people. Good grief, I'm out of where the it'd probably help if I had actually followed the damn markers, and it wouldn't. The red marker storage. Chip Taylor. Nope. Okay. So we go down here, down this way. We're gonna hang on. Left, or a right rather. Common room is inaccessible. Alright, so we just keep going this way. Is that right? Yes. Alright. I don't think I'm in any danger, so I'll keep my weapon lowered. Besides, I took out that one officer like he was nothing. Oh, hey, Butch!
Look who's come waltzing back into the vault.
Yep.
It takes some real balls coming back here after everything you and your dad screwed up. But if you've got to be back, might as well make yourself useful. You gotta help us.
What kind of help?
What sort of help do you think I mean? You must have heard about the changes since you left, right? The deaths, the lies, the whole overseer lockdown thing? Ringing any bells?
A few.
Man, they'd have rushed in here long ago if they didn't know I stole one of their guns from when they issued martial law. Anyway, you gotta help us get out of here. You gotta help me get out of here.
Don't worry, I'm trying to help the entire vault.
Man, screw the entire vault. What about me?
What about you?
Even these rebels just want the option to go outside for lousy trading and stuff. I just want to get the hell out of here for good. Why stay here and be stuck as a barber for my entire life when I could go out there and make my own choices?
Barber. why should I help you?
Because you've always been a goody two-shoes. So when I need help, it's what you're going to do, right?
No.
You're going to help Amata anyway, right?
Yes.
Just make it so we can leave the vault. And I'll leave and never bother you again.
Oh, okay. So what do you think you're going to do out there?
I'll start a gang, of course. Why, it'll be the toughest, coolest, badassest gang the Wasteland's ever seen. Hey, play your cards right, maybe I'll even let you join it, huh?
Oh, can't wait for that one. You have no idea how many gangs of idiot raiders are out there.
Yeah. Well, get us out of here and we'll see, won't we?
Oh, this I've got to see. I'll be going now.
Catch you later. Maybe.
Ooh, Budge. Oh, you are easily the most hilarious person I've ever met. Old Lady Palmer. Oh, hey, you.
Oh, it's good to see you're back from outside. It can be dangerous out there for someone your age.
Gotta go.
Oh, please be
careful. Yeah, you're a nice lady, even though all you did was give me a sweet roll for my 10th birthday. That's right, I haven't forgotten about that. Old senile person. Hey!
Oh my god, you're back!
I'm back!
You got my message and actually came back!
I did.
Oh, thank you! Everything's gone crazy since you left, and now that you're back, you can help set things straight. Chaos doesn't even cover it. It's a nightmare down here. People died that night, and all because my father went crazy to keep someone from opening the vault. And worst of all, then we found out the vault had been opened before, and they'd lied about it all our lives!
Wait, how did you find that out?
After that night, I heard Wally's father say we should never have taken you or your dad into the vault. I found out the vault used to be open, but for some reason, they closed it off when we were babies and swore to hide that it had ever happened. But keeping that lie meant Jonas's death. And even though we know the truth, the Overseer still won't let us make our own decisions.
Sounds like he's gone crazy with power and needs to be stopped.
You're absolutely right. It's not like we want to abandon the vault or anything. Well, Butch does. But he's too big a coward to go out on his own.
Go figure.
Most of us had accepted that the outside was certain death, and things would always stay the same down here. But now we know they don't have to be. After all, it was enough to get you and your dad to leave, so there must be something good out there.
Hit or miss. I think I have a solution to the for the vault's troubles.
I certainly hope so. We can't keep going on like this.
Obviously. I swear I'll stop your father and his girl. No, that sounds kind of violent. Actually, I need to think about this some more.
Damn it!
They say you're threatening the entire vault's safety.
But the vault used to be open, and we're still here, aren't we? It worked back then, so why wouldn't it work now? No, they're just afraid we'll screw up and get hurt. They just won't accept that we can take care of ourselves.
What happened that night?
The real problems came after you two left. The injured had nobody to turn to since our doctor had run off and his assistant had died. Now, we've got to rely on that old Mr. Handy for most of our medical needs. And he hasn't exactly got the best bedside manner.
Oh, really?
Ever had an examination from someone with cold metal pincers? You don't want to.
Let me see what I can do.
Please convince the Overseer to stop the lockdown. We're all counting on you.
Oh, Stanley. Or not Stanley.
It's good to see you again.
Oh, hey, Freddy.
Hey, good to see you again.
Yeah, you too. I can hardly believe they almost shot you.
I tell you, those guards are getting nastier every day. One of these days, it's gonna turn real ugly. But I'll be ready for it.
Oh, really? See you later.
How may I serve you, master?
You can serve me by fucking dying.
What are you going down?
That was for ruining my cake. Anyways, moving on to bigger and better things.
Hello.
Oh, and that was for killing what's-her-face that gave me the poem. Excuse me, Butch.
I never thought you'd be back.
Well, I am back. I'm here to kick ass and chew bubblegum, and I'm all out of bubblegum. Okay. Okay, so we need to go over there. Alright, no, don't want to do that. Actually, is anyone even back there? No?
I don't know how to feel about being back here. For a while, all I wanted to do was go back.
Not so much me.
Come on, pay more attention
to shut up. Oh, wait a minute. Did I screw this up? Okay, there's admin. Okay. Let me see if I can, like, because I don't want to side with the overseer at all.
What do you want? They have to understand that we did that to keep them from going outside and getting killed. To keep them from making the same mistake our generation did when we were their age. Some of us already lost loved ones out there long ago. We won't lose any more today. Oh, do you? What makes you think you know how better to protect this vault?
You simply don't have enough people to stay isolated down here forever.
I admit, in the 200 years since the war, our numbers have dwindled a little. But we have enough genetic diversity for a few more generations.
Mm-hmm.
My God, you're right. We won't last another 100 years, whether or not we get supplies from the outside. We're the last bastion of pure humanity. And we're doomed.
Humanity isn't about pure genetics. It's about never giving up hope, even now.
I wish I could share your optimism. But I suppose you have a point in your blathering way. My way won't save our vault's mission. But if I let them contact the outside world, I might be able to save its inhabitants.
There you go.
But I'm not the one to lead them in that. I'm stepping down as overseer. I'll tell Amata that I can think of no more appropriate leader than she.
Good man. Alright, I actually approve of you now. Congratulations, you're on my good side. If at least for a moment. Alright, overseer, let's go, God, funny thing, me working with him, huh? Then again, stranger and unholier alliances have happened. Hello, Butch.
I never thought you'd be back.
I never thought I'd be back either.
Everyone, listen closely. After a discussion with your friend, I've made an important decision. In my attempts to keep us all safe, I have been, perhaps, overzealous.
That's an understatement.
Lives have been lost. But perhaps, worse than that, lives have been stopped. And in my attempts to keep you safe, I have kept you from growing up. I know I have made these mistakes, and I would make them again if I had to do so. That is why I cannot remain your overseer.
Father!
Amata, I appoint you overseer in my place. You've proven you have what it takes to make hard choices for the good of the vaults. I'm just sorry I didn't understand that earlier. Consider it one of many mistakes I've made.
Good.
Thank you, Father. I'll do my best to keep us all safe, inside the vault and beyond.
You're welcome, my dear. And now, if you'll excuse me, I feel quite worn down.
Well, you made a good choice.
You'll deal with the details soon, in private. Until then, I'm sure there are people waiting to congratulate you.
It's good to see you again. I just heard. My father says he's stepping down as overseer. He won't tell me why, but I have to assume it's something you said to him.
It is. I just had a little talk with him and explained a few things. All quite civil.
You and him? Civil?
I know, right?
I expected you to change out in the wasteland, but not that much. But I guess we'll all be learning a bit about the outside now, won't we? As a new overseer, I'm planning on opening the vault. This time, for good. It's a bright new day for the vault, but I'm afraid there's one thing that has to change.
And that is?
I know you are. And on behalf of the vault, I thank you for all you've done. But there are still many who blame you for everything that happened.
And?
So, I have to ask you to leave. I'm sorry, but the situation is just too delicate for you to stay. Please, if you really want to help the vault, you have to go.
I saved the vault and now you're kicking me out?
No, it's not like that. But if you stay, it'll just keep causing more problems. The vault can't take any more infighting. It's just what has to be.
It'll
be a while before we're ready to really go outside. But once the vault is stable again, maybe we'll see you out there.
Maybe.
So, I guess this is goodbye for now. It's not much, but take this with you to remember us by. With luck, we'll meet again.
Modified utility jumpsuit, alright.
Go on, get out. Good riddance. Get out.
Oh, just one more time since I'm getting kicked out. Oh, please, it's all a daydream. Chill out. Alright, they're all panicking.
Morning.
Where the hell did Butch... Oh, there you are.
It's a shame you gotta go, but you'll do okay.
What the hell?
There, I'm sure.
Oh, yeah, I will. I mean, I've only fought, like, super mutants, slavers, ghouls, giant behemoths, rad roaches, which you're, by the way, scared of. Or which, by the way, you're scared of. That's the upper level. Oh yeah, that's where I need to go anyways. Alright, so we fixed the vault problem. At least I think we did. Leave Vault 101 forever. It's okay, I don't really plan on staying in this place. Overseer's office. Oh yeah, we need to go there. Open overseer's tunnel. Dogmeat, Amanda, we did our job. Let's get the hell out of here for good. Come on. Hey, at least this time we didn't get clobbered by slavers. Alright then, so, I guess we gotta go back there, back to Citadel. Well, now we actually get to see the place in daylight. These marshmallows.
Here's the latest news. Unemployment is down, stocks are up, and the UN has just declared global peace.
Woohoo! Global peace! Citadel Lab. Alrighty. Whoa. Are you guys building Optimus down here?
Consumption actually increasing? We both know that's not an option.
We've been over this. A slight modification to one system and all the subroutines go haywire. Don't worry.
Holy shit, I just saw the robot. Did you see that
thing? Yeah!
Results, not excuses, Rothschild. That robot could mean the difference between victory or defeat against the Enclave.
All right. I'll see what I can do. You honor us with your presence here.
Ah, there you are.
May I start by saying that I am sorry for your loss. I was acquainted with your father many years ago.
Oh, well,
thank you. The world has lost one of its few remaining visionaries.
Well, thank you for your sympathy.
Think nothing of it.
I won't.
Now,
just kidding.
Dr. Lee has explained your predicament. You need to locate some Vault-Tec equipment.
Indeed. My father was looking at something called a Gek. Do you have one?
A Gek? Goodness no, certainly not. I must say that there are some who doubt such a device really exists, let alone works.
Mm-hmm.
If, however, you share your father's determination, I may be able to assist you in locating one.
Sweet. Running short on time here, let's cut to the chase. Huh? It's not even a joke, the video needs to end soon.
Yes, well, I'm afraid that with the emergence of the Enclave, the Brotherhood is rather busy right now.
I don't care.
I elected to take time from my responsibilities to assist you. Perhaps I was in error. Nonetheless, we may have what you seek.
In the archives upstairs is an old pre-war Vault-Tec terminal. I will send word that you need access to it.
It's about damn time. Thanks for the help.
You are welcome. If you require further assistance, I may be able to help.
Yes, I have things for you.
I'm afraid.
Yes. Bring your charge of the young robot. Never mind, I have to go. Wait, old man, come here.
Hail to you, son of James.
Thank y'all. That.
Talk to Scrub.
Jameson, okay, alright then. Actually, wait. Where can I find her?
Spends most
archives, gotcha. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da, gotcha. Gotta go. Bye. Still be with you.
Welcome.
Thank you. See, these guys are a lot more friendly than the damn outcasts. Then again, the outcasts are like zealots in their beliefs. Like, if these guys are zealots, then whatchamacallits are like one step further. Archives. Where are the archives? Archives that way. Courtyard. Armory lab. Hey, lions. I'm glad that we're friends.
Brotherhood is at your service.
And the Brotherhood is very welcoming. Little does the world know that this will later become the Brotherhood of Nod, under the leadership of Cain, formerly known as Antony. Alright, where's this damn archives at? That way.
Happy to report that the development of the Mark II recon armored unit is proceeding as planned.
Okay, gotta love it when things proceed as planned. Where's the damn archives at? Courtyard is there. The den. It's obviously a storeroom of some sort. Citadel B-ring. Barracks. Solar. Library. Ah, there you are.
Hail, outsider. I am Scribe Jameson.
Yeah,
the word of your ordeal has spread. I am truly sorry for the loss of your father. But if I can help you in any way, please let me know.
I found a Brotherhood holotech. What should I do with it?
You have? Oh, my. This brings to light a sad affair for the Brotherhood. But perhaps it is something that you can assist us with. If you have the time, I have an offer for you.
Sure, I've got all the time in the world.
Good. As I'm sure you've noticed, the Brotherhood operates all over the DC ruins, often detached from the main base here at the Citadel.
Mm-hmm.
We're short on communication equipment. So many of the groups in the field operate as independent cells, without standing orders. Sometimes, I'm afraid that their missions end in their deaths. As Keeper of the Scrolls, it's my charge to write of each fallen brother's deeds. Exactly. A brother fallen in the field may have no one to carry word of his death back to me. In calmer times, we could send detachments and messengers to learn their fates. But with our manpower stretched thin, we have no such luxury.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why I must now ask you for your help. Each brother wears a holotag like the one you found. Should you find any of the fallen brethren in the field, I ask that you return their tags to me, so that I might record their deeds in the scrolls.
All right. Talk about something else. Gotta go. Well then, folks. We're in the Brotherhood of Steel's Citadel. We fixed Vault 101's problems, and now we gotta fix our own problems. So, see you all soon.